joint and the ball and socket joint. Remember the hinge joint and the ball and socket joint. In this, one acts like a cup and the other one is like a socket. One is like a ball and the other one is like a socket, so that it fits inside and it can move. Our shoulder joint and our hip joint are the examples of ball and socket joints. Now the next is the pivot joint. Now here you can see this is the skull. In this skull, the part which is connected to the neck, this joint is actually the pivot joint. What is it called as? A pivot joint. Now see, this joint, which joins the skulls to the backbone, is the pivot joint. Now the rod shaped end of one bone fits into the ring type end of the other bone. Can you see this joint? Yes. In this case, the rod shaped vertebral column, the first two vertebrae, fits into a hole. Okay, we have learnt about vertebra in the rib cage, in the skeletal system. Okay, the rod shaped vertebral column fit, the first two, they fit into a hole into the skull here, inside the skull, and it enables the head, this part, it enables the head to move up, to move down, to move sideways. Like you can see, I can move my head up, I can move my head down, and I can also move this sideways. Yes, in the same way, everyone can move it with the help of this pivot joint.